Hey everybody, Leslie Tagorda here, your brand astrologer and designer. And oh my gosh, do we need a little bit of patience? I am recording this on the Friday after the US elections, Friday, November 6th, and we are still patiently awaiting the results of this crucial presidential election. It's no secret that I am a liberal Democrat. I live in San Francisco. I am diverse. I am brown. I believe in choice. I believe in diversity. I believe in inclusion. So, of course, I am rooting for Biden. Now, just because I do believe he's going to win. It hasn't been announced. Probably by the time you hear this, we will have a new president. But our work is not yet done. But we need to have patience, we need to have trust, and we need to have hope. All right. So, has anybody else here been like totally obsessing over this beautiful Netflix mini series called The Queen's Gambit? Oh my gosh, I'm completely obsessed. It is beautiful in all respects. The story is heartwarming, inspirational. The cinematography is just gorgeous. And the lead actress, oh my gosh, she is just beautiful. The clothes and the style and the design and the music. Oh my gosh, I love music. It's, very classical music background, but they did it so well. And of course, I'm a classical musician. Anyway, so without giving away any spoilers, the synopsis is on Netflix. So it's about an orphaned girl who becomes a world-class chess player. And in the very final scene, she kind of struggles with addiction in her entire life. But she calls herself oftentimes an intuitive chess player in the way that she can see the pieces moving. Sometimes they just move for her. And sometimes when she is in kind of her addicted state, she has this vision of a chessboard on the ceiling that the pieces move around. It is just this gorgeous thing. But as she's learning to let go of her addictions, she doesn't trust that her intuition can show up unless she's under the influence. But in the final scene, without giving away any spoilers, she trusts herself without any of her narcotics, or I'm not sure if they're narcotics, her drugs, and she looks up to the ceiling and her intuition comes through and shows her the way. It's just this amazing thing that happens because she has finally figured out how to trust her intuition. So today, with the powerful, upcoming week, we've been in the Scorpio season for so long. Mercury is finally, direct, but we've been able to rethink how we want to use our intuition in our business. We have our third Jupiter Pluto conjunction, our third and final one coming up this week, as well as new moon in Scorpio. So, of course, by design, all of these energies are showing us that we too have to learn to trust our intuition so that we can invest in our evolution. That's what we'll be talking about today. Aloha, welcome to the Savvy Luminary, an astrology podcast for entrepreneurs. I'm your host, Leslie Tagorda, an Aquarius boss woman, a brand designer, and business astrologer. I help visionary spiritual entrepreneurs and impact makers just like you reach your highest potential and become the luminaries you are star charted to be. So I have a beautiful review from Melanie Maxwell that I would like to share with you. She left this on Apple Podcasts. So if you also love this podcast, please be a love and share the love by reviewing and rating this podcast on Apple Podcasts or Stitcher, or even better yet, share this episode with one of your business besties. So Melanie says, I love listening to Leslie's soothing voice, and I love this podcast because I'm very interested in astrology, but I get overwhelmed trying to understand it all. Leslie is amazing and making it simple and also actionable. Ah, Thank you, Melanie. Yes, this is my goal, to make astrology a practical tool for all of us to use to empower ourselves in our business. So in today's episode, I really want to set the stage for us to put together all of the pieces about trust, power, intuition, investment in our lives. So today, let's create the space for our episode. Let's create the intention. And today's intention for our, new moon in Scorpio, our Jupiter-Pluto conjunction in Capricorn, and Mercury returning to Scorpio as it now moves forward, still in the shadow zone of Mercury. Our mantra for today's episode is, I trust and invest in myself. So I invite you to plant yourself firmly on the ground, feel your feet, or if you're sitting, feel your bottom planted in the ground, connecting you to Source above and Mother Earth below. Take a deep, clearing breath, gather all of your energies, and repeat after me. I trust and invest in myself. I trust and invest in myself. So, if you had met me prior to 2018, okay, July 2018, you would have met a very different Leslie Tagorda. All right. You know that I've been running my branding business since 2004 and not really making that many gains. Like, I was lucky enough to have some great customers, but all of our results were, they were fine, but nothing like extravagant, nothing to like write home about, nothing to be like, oh my gosh, I am so proud of what I've created. And back in 2018, I was going through a major crisis. I was like, oh, what am I going to do with my business? This is not giving me joy anymore. Web design and design is just okay. I'd been kind of creating a little bit of astrology things, but not really integrating it together. But I knew I had something more in me. And then, just every time you're going out and looking for something different, the signs start to appear. I started getting signs that, hey, Leslie, you've been running your business for a long time and you've never invested in yourself. You've never got outside of help, thinking you could do it all alone. I mean, yes, I had people on my team, but I never had an advisor to really help kind of focus my energies. And a business coach came right in my path and she asked me to make a freaking big investment. Okay, we're not talking. Well, at first she asked me to make, this is a pretty big investment back for me in 2018. She's like, okay, here, for $5,000, I can give you this training and I'm going to give you everything you need. And I was like, what? $5,000? I can't spend $5,000 on my business. I don't make enough money to spend $5,000 on my business. But as my first investment, I put down the $5,000 and I went through this training thing and I was hooked. I was like, oh my gosh, I need more. So when she, a few months later, said, hey, why don't you join this mastermind for $20,000? Again, my heart sank. But there was something in me that said, Leslie, you need to do this. Find a way. I didn't have $20,000. I didn't even have that $5,000. But let me tell you, when I put that $5,000 in for like those first few months, money just started like coming in much more easily. And I was able to pay back that $5,000. Now, this $20,000, I cleared out my credit card. I called the bank and I said, hey, can you up my credit limit because I want to invest in this thing? And the bank said, yes. Was I scared? Oh my gosh, I have never invested in myself in that way since I went to undergrad. And that was like close to 20 years ago. And so back in 2018, I plunked down $20,000 on a business coach. Now, look at where I am today, 2 years later. Was I scared? Yeah. Did I have the money? No. Did I do it anyway? Yes. Now, some people on the outside may say, oh, you're being irresponsible. But me, as wanting to really invest in myself and invest in my next level evolution, I knew my intuition, my spidey sense, everything in me was saying, Get over the fear, Leslie. Just do it. So the reason why I am telling you this story about investment and trust is that there is this fine line, not a fine line, rather, there is this recipe of patience, trust, and practice, consistency, right? And I put all of these things together. I didn't expect to make my investment back right away, like pronto, like the very next day or even the very next year, right? I knew that it was going to take time. I knew that I was going to constantly have to keep on showing up, keep on doing the work, right? So many of us try something new and just because it didn't work out instantly, we just give up and we don't like think about like, how can I make this better? Do I really want to start doing this? What do I want to keep? What do I want to change, right? These are all the things that we're going through our mind. But there's part of Scorpio season, right? Trust and power and transformation that also has to do with investing in yourself. Scorpio rules the eighth house. And the eighth house in traditional astrology is like death and taxes. But what it really is at its core is leveraging other people's money. Right? Eighth house is the second house from our partnerships. So, you know, if you're married or in like a romantic partnership or even in a business partnership, actually, it's the money that you can leverage that comes in for your use from your partner. That's why death and taxes. So death, when you think about inheritances, that's other people's money that you now get to use. Or if you're leveraging other people's money, like from your partner or taking out a loan because you trust yourself and investing, all eighth house, all ruled by Scorpio. Scorpio's one of the co-ruler, planetary co-rulers of Scorpio is Pluto. Right? So do you see how all of this is coming together this week for you to really learn how to trust in yourself and learn how to decide if this is the right time to invest in your future? To me, when I see it astrologically, I'm saying it's a big yes. Figuring out where you need to invest in yourself and using this upcoming new moon, we're going to be talking all about that, to figure out how to trust in your intuition and where you need to invest in your business. So I wanted to also add on, right? Once I started investing in myself, oh my gosh, there's a couple of things that happened. I couldn't stop investing in myself. Actually, I still continue to invest in my business today. And my business is like 180 compared to where it was 2 years ago. I want to talk a little bit about money, not to focus on money per se, but you know, money is an energy force. It's this place of abundance, right? It's the energy that we can receive, and it takes a lot of mindset. Now, I don't have my mindset all figured out. Let me tell you, like there's still things that really freak me out in terms of like, oh, I can't charge that much. Am I worthy enough? You know, I still have debt that I'm paying off, but I'm not afraid of debt anymore. I look at it as this thing that allows me to grow. So even with this podcast, I'm not yet a year into it, right? And I look at my metrics and I look at how my business has grown, and only recently did this podcast really start to blossom, right? I committed back in February that I was going to really take this and spend an entire year providing weekly episodes. That is a huge commitment that I put a lot of resources in, not only money, but my time resources, Jeff's resources. You hear me talk about Jeff a lot. He produces these podcasts. He helps me in my business. And, you know, when we were planning out the podcast at the beginning of the year, I wanted to go big, right? I mentioned that I'd started a party. You can see still party highlights on, you know, thesavvyluminary.com. I invested in a party. I rented out this big bar. I made all these goodie bags. I probably plunked down like $7,000 at the end of the day. Like I had, you know, Shammy, I brought Shammy up from LA to be the DJ. My birthday's on Valentine's Day. And so, you know, already a hard night to throw a party because everybody wants to do things. But I was expecting, there was a part of me that was really, really, really hoping for like instant, like boom, viral, like, oh my God, Leslie's amazing. And I was going to make my $7,000 back really quickly. But no, it didn't work that way. But now, come to November, you know, almost a year, 9 months, the baby has finally formed, right? My podcast is kind of at a tipping point. I feel that it is a beautiful tool to spread the word about astrology-based branding and astrology in our business to help give us clarity and meaning. It's so wonderful and it's just starting to ripple out. So again, we come back to this patience, right? Not to expect an overnight return on investment, but letting it grow and trusting in this process. So that's the other story I wanted to tell you today. And now let's talk a little bit about the astrology of the upcoming week, because this really brings us to the new moon, right? So we have a new moon on Saturday, November 14th, if you're on the, you know, the Western Hemisphere, Western Hemisphere, if you're like in the Americas, if you're in Europe and in the Pacific, Australia, New Zealand, your new moon happens on Sunday the 15th. But all of the energies that we've been, you know, kind of culminating and digesting and absorbing since, you know, pretty much this entire year is coming up to a culmination, with the crowning jewel being our new moon in Scorpio, so that we can personally plant the seeds of trust, of investment. The biggest thing that is happening next week is on Thursday, November 12th, we have our third and final Jupiter-Pluto conjunction in Capricorn. So you've been hearing about this all year. Oh my gosh, 2020 has been a year like no others, where we have three major outer planets. Well, they're all major. The three outer planets, Jupiter, Saturn, and Pluto, all year coming together in the sign of Capricorn, right? Saturn structures, Jupiter expansion, Pluto intensity. And each of those coming together, all three of them, all year, dancing with each other, dancing with each other. We're not done yet. We still have Jupiter and Saturn coming up in December. But the final Pluto-Jupiter conjunction happening. So when we just look at taking together Pluto and Jupiter, Jupiter, our planet of expansion, our planet of optimism, of hope. You know, it's wonderful things that Jupiter represents. But you know, Jupiter doesn't really think about what it's expanding. It's just kind of like this magnifying glass. And Pluto kind of like amplifies it even more, because Pluto is the planet of distillation. So rather than expanding, it intensifies things. Thinking of like, you know, okay, so we have the magnifying glass, but now we got the magnifying glass and like the noon sunlight is coming and just like burning and crystallizing everything until it's just the essence that we have in Pluto, all in Capricorn. So we can see this, you know, in our society as the structures that are coming to a close, right? One thing is ending, but a new thing is beginning. Anytime two planets form a conjunction, it is the beginning of the cycle, just like a new moon. A new moon is when the sun and the moon come into conjunction, the beginning of a cycle. When we think about the cycle that Jupiter and Pluto represent on a society level, right? Capricorn structures, governmental structures, societal structures, but in our businesses and our lives, literally our business. Capricorn is all about business. So this new cycle between Jupiter and Pluto means an expansion and a transformation in our business structures, okay? So basically, a new evolution, a new possibility, a new idealization, right? Jupiter and Pluto, the beginning. So because we had this cycle three times this year, the way the outer planets move, they move so slowly. You know, Jupiter takes about 12 years to go through the zodiac. Pluto takes 284. So every 12 years, Jupiter and Pluto will meet up in the sky, allowing us to create a new cycle of evolution for us. And then you notice that Jupiter, these outer planets, they look like they're going backwards for half the year and they're coming forward. And so just the natural progression of it, when these outer planets meet in the sky, they meet in usually in the sets of three, right? So we had our first Jupiter expansion, Pluto transformation, the first meeting back in April of 2020. Then we had this meeting back again in June, the second meeting while they were going retrograde. And now that they're going forward again, this third and final meeting on November 12th. So each of these three meetings are also super significant. The first meeting back in April, the starting of the cycle, right? We can't start something new until we close something down. So in April, likely we can think back in the pandemic at the very beginning of like the lockdown of COVID, like things were so uncertain. Everything started to crumble, right? Everything, you know, your ability to travel, expand yourself, expansion, all those things that Jupiter represented just weren't going to work anymore, right? What came down for you thinking back in April in your business? What pieces came apart? Then in June, you have all of this rubble, right? All of these different pieces. Now you're going to rebuild some of this rubble, but some of this rubble you just have to throw out because it's just not usable anymore, right? So in June, you had this kind of assessment of all of this rubble from your business. What has changed? Now we get to put the pieces back. This is so freaking exciting. I get so, like, you can hear my voice. Okay, calm down, Leslie. Starting in November, from November until, you know, we get this new moon, you get to plant your seeds. November 12th, when Jupiter and Pluto meet again, you get to decide what new expansive transformational systems and ideologies you want to build in your business. This is just like evolutionary, like your next evolution. You have to decide. If you're not thinking about with clarity what you want to build coming up in the future, guess what? Nothing is going to get built, right? You can't just start putting bricks together without figuring out like, oh, I want a house with three bedrooms and a backyard, right? You can't just start putting bricks together. You have to have a vision, an evolution of what you want to create, and you get to do it starting on November 12th when Jupiter and Pluto meet. And then when Jupiter and Saturn meet in December, that's coming up, and that's a whole nother episode. When Jupiter and Saturn meet, now Jupiter, all that vision is going to have structure. This is a freaking potent time of the year for you to really start thinking about what you're going to build in the future. And because things are so uncertain, and because we need patience and we need trust, we need to keep our energy high, right? We need to have hope. We need to have trust. We need to have enthusiasm and optimism. Go the high road, because you know what? This is not going to be easy. Okay. This is going to be intense. So fast forward, you got the Pluto and Jupiter conjunction, evolution. Okay. If you're going to remember anything about November 12th, is this is when you're going to be able to decide on what you want to create going in the future. And then new moon comes up. Just a couple of days after that, new moon in Scorpio, we need trust, we need patience, we need to invest. So those things you're going to get to plant in your business to help you take you to that next evolution. Okay. I just want to make sure that that's very clear. You're deciding Jupiter and Pluto conjunction, you're deciding on what that next evolution in your business you want to have. And you need trust, you need patience, you need to be able to invest in yourself to be able to get you to that next evolution. And so you're going to plant on the new moon what you need to trust and empower and invest in yourself using your intuition on that Scorpio new moon. So Scorpio new moon again happens on November 14th, 2020 at 9:08 p.m. Pacific. or November 15th at 12:08 a.m. Eastern. And everybody else, please use the time zone converter to figure out your times. My brain doesn't work like that. At the time of the new moon, when the moon and sun meet at 23 degrees of Scorpio, we have some other energies that are really supporting us. So remember that Pluto and Jupiter are also meeting on the 12th. They're meeting at 22 degrees. Okay, so just 1 degree off. So Scorpio and Capricorn at 22, 23 degrees forms a sextile. A sextile is the relationship between all of those energies, right? That is a little bit less potent than a trine. A trine is harmonious and in flow and very supportive. A sextile has that same kind of energy, like the creative opportunities and support, but you gotta put in the work, okay? This is not like anything is gonna just like a windfall is just gonna happen for you. I mean, you may have energies that support that, but this is you really putting in the work, really making those decisions, really getting super clear on what you want, putting an action plan forward, and actually doing these things, right? Trusting yourself, trusting in consistency, and trusting on, if you make a mistake or things don't work out exactly as you plan, like getting back up and trying it out again. Okay. So, new moon has that sextile. So, all those creative opportunities to help you support, to help you figure out, to help you with consistency practice, right? We also have Venus in Libra, squaring, right? The Jupiter and Pluto in Capricorn. And so, Venus, normally you hear a square and you're like, oh, that's kind of a difficult angle. But whenever Venus is involved, there's nothing really difficult with Venus. Venus is just asking you, like, yes, use your resources. And because Venus is in Libra, call in your people, right? So if we go back to the very beginning theme of understanding Scorpio as also one of the energies that we need to use in investing, right? Using other people's resources, other people's money. So Libra in Venus in Libra is about connecting to your people resources. Who can you ask for money if traditional loaning options don't work for you, right? If you can't, if your credit card is already maxed out and you don't have credit there, or you can't apply for a loan, who else can you get, who else can help you with some money, right? There are so many opportunities for you in this new moon if you get really clear. Trust your intuition and trust in yourself to invest in yourself and have the patience and the consistency to really practice and harness that so that your investment pays off. So I'd love to invite you if you want to attend a new moon circle. I would love to invite you to my wonderful new moon ceremonies. We will be focusing on Scorpio. I will be giving mini readings to the first 10 people that register for the class and show up live. We are doing this on Monday, November 16th. It's right after the new moon, but still within that new moon window. And it's going to be at 2 p.m. Pacific, 5 p.m. Eastern. If you would like to join us, please head over to thesavvyluminary.com/new moon. It's pay what you can. I'd rather have you there than miss it if you can join us and make space for us. But a suggested registration fee of $47 to $97, depending on your financial situation. So, I always talk about new moons. And if you go to the show notes, you can learn more about Scorpio energy because, gosh, we have been talking about Scorpio for so long. If you go back to episode 39, you can learn about how to use your powerful Scorpio energy in your business. And then any of my new moon episodes will talk about why you want to do a new moon ritual and how to do a new moon ritual. Just to recap, you want to do a new moon ritual because this is the time to plant the seeds during the darkness of the moon when the moon and sun meet, right? You want to create space in your life and business to get really clear with what you want. And remember, when you're throwing a new moon ritual, you want to clear space. You want to bring in your well ancestors, and you want to be as expansive, setting intentions versus goals, using your feelings and your beliefs of what you want and why you want it, rather than focusing on finite endings, like how much money you want to bring in. On social media, I'll be posting, the house by house activations. I won't go through it all here today. But basically, you're going to be planting your seeds of trust in your intuition, your authentic power, and your investment power in your business. How exciting is that? So, to recap, we have one of our most powerful weeks coming up of all of the year. It is your time to get really clear on the next evolution of your business. It is time to get really clear that you can use and tap into your authentic power, your intuition, to make the right decisions in your business. And that you too can invest in yourself. You don't need to wait to have the money to invest in yourself. So, looking at your new moon in Scorpio activation is going to give you some insight as to where you might want to invest in your business based on the houses. And a reminder, you are invited to my new moon in Scorpio ceremony. We'll be talking about what we want to invest in, how to trust in ourselves, and we'll be talking, I'll be giving 10 mini readings to the first 10 people that sign up and attend live. To register, head over to thesavvyluminary.com/new moon. All right. So thank you so much for making space in your week, for having me chat with you. Let's close out our energy and really embody and reaffirm our mantra that we opened up with today. Take a beautiful, clearing breath. Plant your feet firmly on the ground. Connect to your highest self. And repeat after me. I trust and invest in myself. I trust and invest in myself. Thank you for joining me this week. Until next week, take care. Mahalo for listening to this brand new podcast. If you enjoyed learning about astrology for entrepreneurs, help me spread the word by sharing this podcast with your business besties. And hop over to The Savvy Luminary for links to episode notes and our free Facebook community where you can send me questions about astrology or branding, as well as connect with other like-minded businesses.